In Guaynabo, on the outskirts of San Juan, mourners say goodbye to one of the neighborhood's most loved residents. Her man, Alejandro Rosa, stood on this street corner for years selling lottery tickets. The 71-year-old was shot and killed for the few dollars in his pocket, shocking residents of a neighborhood many consider safe.
We have a loss of a friend, a good father, a really good person that helped everybody. And we are very, very sad that our country.
But with a murder rate six times that of the continental United States, most people here feel powerless to stop a crime wave that's permeated every part of this island. The U.S. government's added resources to help secure the maritime borders, and last year's Operation Caribbean Resilience led to the arrests of more than 300 people. But it's simply not enough.
Bloody crime scenes are common as drug gangs fight for control of a multi-billion dollar cocaine trade. In 2011, Puerto Rico broke its own records by logging more than 1,000 murders. The rate has fallen since, but remains unacceptably high.
No estoy muy seguro en eso.
And this is the man who, for the last 18 months, has been charged with the seemingly insurmountable task of tackling crime. In a few days, Hector Pesquera will step down as police chief, but not before expressing disappointment in what he calls institutional failures.
Yes, I do get angry, and I let it out sometimes, maybe more often than I should. But it bothers me that because of inaction, people are being killed here every day.
But Herman Alejandro Rosa's son has heard enough talk. He wants his father's death to bring change to an island in deep trouble.
We have to stand up and go to deliver the message, because it's the only way. If the person don't hear that, those crimes are gonna continue. We have to stop that.
But stopping or even containing the violence here may be the biggest challenge Puerto Rico is yet to face. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, San Juan, Puerto Rico.